Now I'd like to cover a very important topic. That is the difference between voltage difference and node voltage. This is a problem right here where we're assuming that most of the node voltages have been measured. Let me show you what the node voltages are. So let's circle the node voltages. V1 right here, that's the ground, so that's equal to 0. V2 is a node voltage that hasn't been measured. Let's see what V2 is going to be. We can see that we have a ground right here, which is 0 volts, and that applies to this whole region right here. Any place that I measure there is going to be V0, so that's node 1. Now let's actually look at node 2. I'm going to make that one green instead of red. And that's going to apply to this whole region right here. That's V2. All right, we can see that V2 is 48 volts above the ground, so V2 is going to be equal to 48. Let's see what other nodes we have. Here's node V3. Node V3 applies to this whole region right here between these two resistors and, in fact, down there as well. Let's check out one more node. Let's get the purple one. Right here is V5, and right here is V4. So those are two more nodes. So I've circled all of the node voltages. Difference voltages, and let me just get black to show you those, are the voltages that are across a resistor like this. So we have V5 on the top. I'm going to put a plus sign there, and we have V1 on the bottom. So this node, voltage difference is going to be V5 1, which is going to be equal to V5 minus V1. Now maybe that's a little hard to see. Let me just erase it. Let's just write down here V5 1 is equal to V5 minus V1. All right, let's put some numbers to that. V5 is 20 and V1 is 0, so this is 20 volts. Now let's see about the voltage across R4. I can choose to look from V3 to V5 or V5 to V3. Let's consider V3 5. I can consider either of them when I'm doing this problem. I'll just get a positive sign for one and a negative sign for the other. So V3 5 is going to be equal to V3 minus V5, which is equal to 32 minus 20, or 12 volts. Let's look at this difference. Which one's that going to be? Well, V3 is on the top, where the plus sign is, and V2 is on the bottom, where the minus sign is, so this is going to be V3 2. That's going to be equal to V3 minus V2, which is going to be 32 minus 48, or minus 16 volts. Let's look at the voltage right here. Plus to minus, that's going to be V3 is the plus sign, 2 is the minus, I'm sorry, 4 is the minus sign. So that's going to be V3 minus V4, which is going to be 22 volts. Let's look at this one. It's plus here, that's V4, and minus right there, which is V1. So it's V4 1, which is V4 minus V1, which is 10 volts. Okay, what we've just done is we've calculated all of the node voltages as well as all of the voltage differences. The node voltages are the ones that have a single number, V1, V2, V3, V4, and V5. They're the ones I've circled. The difference voltages are the ones that have two numbers, like V5 1, V5 3, V3 2, V3 4, and V4 1. Now, here's a really interesting concept. Let's see how those are measured. Remember, in general, that voltage is a potential difference and it's measured between two points. We use a voltmeter like this, and we take the red line and we put it where we want the positive part of the voltage to be, and we take the negative line and we put it where the negative part of the voltage is. So when we do a measurement like this, it's going to be measuring VAB, which is VA minus VB. What's our voltmeter measuring? It's actually measuring a difference between two points. Now let's see how to use that. Let's suppose that I wanted to measure the difference between two points. Well, remember, for example, that we had V5 1. What was that? It was 20 minus 0, or 20 volts. How would we measure that? We would take our voltmeter, like this, and we connect our positive line to V5 and our negative line to V1, and that's how we would measure V5.1. Now, what if I wanted to measure a node voltage? What I would do in that case is I would take my voltmeter, I would put my negative line on the ground, and I would take my positive line and I would put it on the voltage that I wanted to measure. Then if I wanted to measure, this is how I would measure V2, if I wanted to measure V3, I would instead bring my positive line, this is the positive line, this was the positive line, I'd bring that up to V3. The negative line would stay there on ground. So let's review that. To measure a node voltage, what you're going to do is connect the red line, let's actually make this ink red so you can see it, connect the red line to the voltage, to the node that you want to measure. Let's suppose that we want to measure V5. And then you connect the black line onto the ground. That's how we'd measure V5. Now let's show the same picture if instead of V5, I want to measure V3. What shall I change about my connection? Because I'm measuring a node voltage, I'm going to leave the black line on ground, but I'm going to bring my red line, instead of to V5, I'm going to bring the red line over to V3. The dashed line shows you how you would measure V3 instead of V5. Okay, now let's consider how we would measure a voltage difference. To measure a voltage difference, we would connect the red line onto VA, the first voltage that we want to measure, and we would connect the black line where the VB is. So this is considered VB, and this is considered VA. In this picture, what I would be measuring is V3 minus V5, or V3.5. Okay, let's imagine what this should look like if I wanted to measure, let's say, V3.2. All right, that's V3 minus V2. What do I need to change about this picture? I need to bring, I can leave my red line where it is because I'm measuring V3, and the black line would come over here to V2. Now I would be measuring V3.2. Now imagine what it would look like if I wanted to measure V4.1, like this. What would you do? I would take my voltmeter, like this. I would take the positive line up here, and I would take the negative line right there. That's how I'd measure V4.1. So let's go back and compare. Get this out of my way so I can go back. Okay, this is what it looks like to measure a node voltage. If I'm measuring a node voltage, my black line is always on ground. That's how I measure a node voltage. The black is always connected to ground. But if I want to measure a voltage difference, the red is connected to the node I want to the first node, and the black is connected to the second node. So both the red line and the black line move around if I want to measure a voltage difference. Now, let's imagine what would happen if I wanted to move the ground in my circuit. What would be changing? If I change the ground, the node voltages will change. All of these node voltages will change because I'm changing one of my nodes. All the node voltages will change, but what will not change are all the difference voltages. So, for example, V5.1 is exactly the same as what it was before, and V3.4 is the same as what it used to be. So what I do in order to solve problem 1.25 is I find all of the different difference voltages, we found those before, and then I want to find the voltage relative to V2. So I'm going to take just a minute, I'm going to pause this video, and I'm going to write in all of the difference voltages so that we can do this problem with the ground in a little different place. Okay, I've written all of the voltage differences in here. Remember, V51 was 20 volts, V35 was 12, V34 was 22, V32 is minus 16, and V41 is 10. Now, what I want to do is move my ground right here to this point, so that means this whole section right there is grounded, and that sets V2 equal to 0. Now let's find each of the other node voltages. Okay, let's find V1. So V1 minus V2 is going to be equal to, what I'm going to do is take a line and just draw it right down through there. I hit the minus sign first and then the plus sign, so this is going to be minus 48 volts. Now let's find V3. So V3, I'm going to take a line, I'm going to draw it from V3 down to V2, and I will say that V32 is V3 minus V2. We can see that V2 is equal to 0, so V3 is minus 16 volts. Now let's look for V4. A way to do this is to observe that V34 is equal to 22 volts. That's equal to V3 minus V4. Do we know what V3 is yet? Yep, we found V3 right here, minus 16 volts. Plug that in there, and we find out that V4 is minus 38 volts. Now let's find V5. We know that V51 is equal to V5 minus V1. We know what V1 is. So this means that, I'm just going to say means that, V5 is equal to V51, which is 20 volts, plus V1, which, where's V1? Okay, right here, minus 48 volts, minus 48 volts, so this is equal to minus 28 volts. So we can use the concept of voltage difference to help us find the node voltages as soon as we know what the ground is. So let's basically review what we did. We started out, let's go back. We started out the problem with several node voltages that had been measured, and from those we calculated difference voltages. We started out with those with a single number, we calculated those with two numbers, and then we used those later when we moved the ground. We reviewed the idea that voltage is the potential difference between two points, and we talked about how you could use that to measure the node voltage as well as the voltage difference. Remember, to measure the node voltage, you keep the black line on the ground and the red line on the node you want, and if you want to measure the difference, you put the red line where the first number, A, is, and you put the black line where the second number, B, is. We use this idea also to find the voltage differences across each of the resistors like this. Finally, we just copied the voltage differences. The voltage differences do not change. No matter where you put the ground, the voltage differences stay the same. The node voltages, the single numbers, are the ones that change when you move the ground, but the voltage differences stay the same. So we simply copied all the voltage differences, and then we used those to find the node voltages. I hope that helps you understand the difference between node voltage and voltage difference. If you have any other questions, please post them on our discussion boards. Thank you.